This historical marker is located in Butler County, Pennsylvania, honoring some of the local victims from the most devastating single disease outbreak in modern history. It was the Great Influenza Pandemic of 1918. By early fall, many Americans were dying from a mysterious, deadly influenza, which spread quickly from military camps to civilians. What happened next became known as the deadliest parade in American history. On September 28, 1918, around 200,000 people crammed the streets of Philadelphia to watch the 2-mile Liberty Loan Parade, meant to raise funds for the war effort. Unfortunately, Director of Public Health Dr. Wilmer Krusen ignored the advice of medical professionals who urged him to cancel the parade or risk an epidemic. Krusen downplayed the danger of spreading the disease, knowing that the parade would raise millions of dollars in war bonds. Within a week, every bed in Philadelphia's 31 hospitals were filled with 45,000 citizens afflicted with influenza. In a prime example of what to do during a looming pandemic, St. Louis decided to cancel their parade. By October 1918, more than 12,000 people in Philadelphia died from pandemic flu, while the death toll in St. Louis did not rise above 700. During this deadly time, an estimated 675,000 Americans died in less than 2 years. To put that number in perspective, that is more than all the American soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, Korea, Vietnam, Iraq, and Afghanistan combined. In 1918, as the war was winding down in Europe, this new and very contagious influenza virus materialized, and it was spreading quickly. When U.S. troops deployed en masse for the war effort in Europe, they carried the Spanish flu with them. The virus spread like wildfire through England, France, Spain, and Italy. An estimated 3/4 of the French military were infected, and as many as half of the British troops. In 1918, doctors could do little to treat this pandemic. They had no vaccines, no antiviral drugs, and no antibiotics to stop the bacterial pneumonia that often comes with bad cases of the flu. Doctors around the world had no idea what was causing the flu. But this didn't stop scientists and doctors from doing something, anything, to combat the pandemic. Enemas, mercury, tree bark, dry champagne, bloodletting, these were some of the medical interventions doctors used during the 1918 Spanish flu pandemic. Early on, British doctors wrote, "So far, we have been unable to find anything that has any real influence on the course of the disease." It is estimated that about 500 million people, or 1/3 of the world's population, became infected with this virus between 1918 and 1919. Ultimately, the death toll was estimated to be between 50 and 100 million people worldwide. After a century of medical and scientific breakthroughs, influenza still taunts us. We now have a deep understanding of the virus, but still lack a 100% effective vaccine. The question is, will we have one ready in time for the next inevitable pandemic? Please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell to stay informed on the latest videos. If history can be taught with stories, it can never be forgotten.